Jeff Gordon, the 24-year-old who was born in California but grew up on the dirt tracks and the short paved tracks in Indiana and the Midwest, sits in his car today waiting for this race to begin. He is so close to winning the 1995 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship, one of the most coveted prizes in all of auto racing. The young man looks cool. He has 500 miles ahead of him. If he can lead one lap and if one car falls out of the race, the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship will be his for 1995. Dale Earnhardt is the only other driver that can catch him.
And today, to honor the most famous words in sport, we are proud to have Edsel Ford and his son, Calvin. Gentlemen, go to it.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Well, step number one has been accomplished for Jeff, whose DuPont Chevrolet has fired on the grid. One step closer to the 95 championship, which will be decided today here at Atlanta Motor Speedway.
Ray Evernham, 10 months and over 11,000 miles of racing. It all comes down to today. How do you play your cards?
Well, it's been a lifetime, I guess more than 10 months. It's been a lifetime, a lot of effort by a lot of people. And the only way we can play our cards is to go out and try and win this race. You know, we want to be competitive. We haven't run good, we don't feel, since Dover, and we want to be competitive and take Rick Hendrick to victory lane one more time this year.
Jeff Gordon's teammate, Kent Schrader, has entered this car as sort of an insurance policy in Gordon's bid for the Winston Cup. If something should happen to Jeff, this car could still finish behind Gordon, and he could win his first Winston Cup championship. Now, the sponsor, also near and dear to Gordon's crew chief, Ray Evernham, Leukemia Society of America. That's because his young son, Ray J, has leukemia, although it is in remission. Proceeds from this car will go to benefit the Leukemia Society of America in racing for a reason. Now, Jimmy Horton was supposed to have driven this car today, but of course he is in a local hospital, injured in a wreck yesterday in the ARCA race. So Jeff Purvis will drive.
Car owner Rick Hendrick, you started so small, you've worked so hard, you've been so close. Your car has fired. You're on the verge of your first championship. How does it feel?
Boy, it's hard to explain when, you know, when they play the national anthem and you stand here and, you know, you've been waiting, working for this for so long, for our whole organization, the race teams, the dealerships, our friends, everyone that's here. It's been a great experience, and, you know, hello to everybody at home, and we just wish everybody could have been here, but we hope we can get it done here in a little bit and celebrate this thing.
Well, we're waiting on step number two, which is when the car will move away from the grid. And if one car, any car in the other 41 starting here this afternoon, can drop out of the race, then the championship will be Jeff Gordon's. Hi, everyone. I'm Bob Jenkins. And geographically and on the calendar, it isn't a very long road from Daytona in February to Atlanta in November. But really, it's been a very hard-fought road consisting of over 11,000 miles. But it all ends here this afternoon, and yes, Jeff Gordon will probably be the champion, but don't go away. Anything can happen. What I'd like to know is, Ned and Benny, what's going through Jeff's mind right now?
Bob, this is the moment that he has been waiting for, a time that he could get strapped in that number 24 Chevrolet all alone. Doesn't have to face those questions anymore. 2 weeks of it since Phoenix, knowing that he could lock this championship up so easy. But he would like for the race to have been last week or the next day after the Phoenix race. But now he's sitting in there, probably the most relaxed he's been in a couple of weeks.
Boy, I tell you, all the questions he's been asked the last couple of weeks, stupid questions. I've probably asked him six myself, and the crew members, they've looked at every part on the race car at least three times. Is this good enough to win a championship with? Now all the parts are on, the best parts they got, they're on the race car. They want to see this race over, get the 95 championship behind them, go to Daytona, and try to get a championship in 1996.
There was a lot at stake today, money-wise. $3.3 million. Jeff Gordon could become the first $4 million winner in racing history. Indeed, Jeff Gordon's car is rolling, so step number two has been accomplished. That's crucial, of course, because if one car does not start or when one car drops out, The championship is over. That car.
Bob, some anxious moments this morning in the garage area for the DuPont team. They were checking the motor. They had for the race today and found some metal. Actually, one of the tubes had fallen off inside the valve cover that oils the valve springs. They couldn't find the parts of the tube. They said, we can't take a chance. That part of the tube could go down in the oil pump and knock off the belt. The engine could lock up for the first lap, and we can't take a chance. So they changed the motor this morning about an hour before race time, and actually Ray Evernham said it's the best thing that could happen to this crew. It helped relax them. They were sitting around with so much nervous energy. When we put them to work, they suddenly were able to relax. But they have a fresh engine in this car, has not had a lap on the racetrack.
Let's check our Napa starting lineup for today's 500-mile finale of the 95 season. Well, guys, it's time to settle it. It has been a long road. It's a beautiful day after rain, of course, here yesterday. Quite cool this morning, but the sun is shining, and it should be very comfortable for the race fans. The crowd has risen to its feet, everyone waving and cheering for the start of the final race of the year. Here they come for the green. It is out, and Waltrip nails the gas. We're underway for the finale of 95.
Championship if Jeff Purvis does not return to the track. The car is running. Purvis is sitting in the car. The crew talking it over on the radio. This could be the final moment of Jeff Gordon's long road to the Winston Cup Championship. Right now, this car sits here as Gordon chases the 1995 title.
Ricky Rudd has taken the lead. There are Gordon and Earnhardt running close together on the racetrack. The Rick Hendrick 2 crew had told us that they really wouldn't do that. They wouldn't park the car early, but they either are doing that or it does have a legitimate problem. But now it's rolling, and Purvis is back out onto the racetrack as we follow the action on the backstretch and into turn number 3. John Kernan has more on this situation.
Bob, I was just talking to Jeff Purvis just moments before they fired the engines here, and Jeff told me, he says, hey, I'm feeling kind of bad myself. I've got a little case of the flu. In fact, he says, if I can make it to halfway and I don't feel too good, you think you can get in that car and finish the race for me?
Up front, it is Ricky Rudd with Bobby Hamilton running in second position. There is Gordon behind Jeremy Mayfield.
Dale Earnhardt knows now that the championship is over, that Jeff Gordon is in fact going to be the 1995 Winston Cup champion.
Dale Earnhardt must lead the most laps. He must win the race to secure the title for himself, and Jeff must finish 41st or 42nd. Not likely to happen. Now we're watching from Mark Martin's perspective of Jeff Gordon just ahead.
Now the car number 58 is 2 laps down, so if something does happen to Jeff Gordon, well, he still wouldn't finish last.
Bill Weber again on pit road.
Exactly right, Ned. They call it an insurance lap. Crew chief Bill Hammer told me that's exactly what they did. They brought him in. Now they're going to run for the Leukemia Society, but Jeff Gordon has an insurance car a lap or so off the pace.
So that pretty much does it for the championship. We're going to wait to declare him officially the winner, however, as we continue to watch the action.
He's trying to get the top 10.
Bobby Hamilton is 13th coming into this event in the points. Jeff Gordon has passed Jeremy Mayfield and now moved into 8th position.
Yeah, he took it easy there for a few laps, and now he apparently is going to put the hammer down and go on and try to win the race.
The leader is Bobby Hamilton.
We got a smoker up here.
Smoker. Who is it, Ned?
And it's Ken Schrader, I believe. It's a red car. Oh, man, that's the bad luck that guy has had this year. Now, that could definitely lock up the
the championship for sure if he can't finish this race. It looks like he's going to be out in a lot of smoke from the Budweiser Chevrolet.
If it is a terminal problem that will force him to the garage area and a problem that will not be fixed or cannot be fixed, then that will definitely give Jeff the championship. The car in trouble, Ken Schrader, his teammate. Jeff Gordon, meanwhile, is looking pretty racy, going to the inside of Dick Trickle and going into seventh spot. Up front, it is Bobby Hamilton leading Ricky Rudd with 10 laps out of 328 completed in the Napa 500, the final race of the 1995 Winston Cup season. ESPN Speed World coverage of the Napa 500 is being brought to you by Napa Auto Parts. We keep America running by Pennzoil.
I believe Jeff Gordon's a slouch right now. He's at the tail end of this group. And he fell back a little bit at the early start, at the start of the race. There he is behind Michael Walker. But
Jeff is running in seventh position as another Napa field summary comes your way, showing you where all drivers are running at the moment.
And Dick Trickle is the one that has really dropped back, Bob. He started up there in the fourth position, and he's all the way back to, what, 28th position.
Now Michael Waltrip looking to the inside of Hamilton. Why isn't Gordon moving up, Jerry?
Well, Bob, Jeff has radioed to the crew that his car is very tight in the middle of the corner out. It's good getting in the corner, so Ray said basically be very careful. He moved to the inside of Bobby Hamilton to take the spot away. Of course, Michael Walker's already going around Hamilton, but he said just be patient. The track will come to you. We're good going in, but tight in the middle, so don't get cramped out on the inside.
Well, Gordon did pass Hamilton to take over that position, and now he moves to the inside of Waltrip, pitch of the Napa 500 from Atlanta in just a moment. Jeff Gordon running in fourth position at the moment. We cannot declare Jeff the champion yet because Ken's car will go back out onto the racetrack, but again, the scenario looks very good for Jeff Gordon.
Oh, yes, it is.
He won the event back in 91, and look at Jeff Gordon and Sterling Marlin. Something must be wrong with Rusty. Is he coming in? No, he's back there on the backstretch. Obviously, it's in slowing for that at that point on the racetrack, but he sure got past there by a couple of cars.
Yeah, I think those guys' cars are just handling better on the old tires.
Rusty all of a sudden has got some serious problems. The car is very, very slow. He was up in second place or third place.
Jeff Gordon is second. Is Jeff waiting for Sterling to make the move? Jeff can lead the lap and lock up the championship.
I'm sure he'd like to see the four car come in right now and put that totally behind him. You know, the 25 car, his teammate, the Ken Schrader car, has been in the garage area for 48 laps, but he's not officially out of the race. There he comes. He just went, came in for some new tires a couple of laps ago.
Jeff Gordon cannot afford to wait on Sterling Marlin because his car had just simply gone away. He's losing a tremendous amount of distance between himself and Sterling Marlin. And he's losing a lot of distance to Earnhardt, Waltrip, all the rest of the guys that have made their pit stops. So he will be coming in soon. We can see how far he's fallen behind Sterling Marlin.
Marlin crew apparently is getting ready for Sterling to come in, and Marlin may be doing so this lap.
Yeah, there are a lot of cars that have been in the pits are passing him right now, so he needs to come in because he's going to be losing a lot of time. Yeah, he's coming into the pit right now.
All right, Marlin comes in. Let's see if Jeff staves out. He will, and Jeff Gordon is going to lead this lap, and that gives him the championship.
Our 1995 champion.
Jeff Gordon, after leading that lap, is headed to his pit area.
Here comes the DuPont Chevrolet.
And Bob, with all of this pit stops and everything, we see Jeff Gordon make this. Ken Schrader just gone back out of the garage area. Now let's go to the pits and Jerry Punch.
Well, Ray Everham just said, come on in and pit, champion. And Jeff, I don't think can say much of that. It's the first time he's ever heard that. He is a Winston Cup champion. They will change four tires, an emotional crew. They've been high-fiving, shaking hands, and they will service their driver. And now they can turn around and take time to celebrate.
Well, the man whose professional career we have followed from its inception here on ESPN has captured one of the most coveted prizes in all of auto racing. from the first time that we saw him and the first time that he appeared on Speed Week at the age of 13 when he was down at East Bay Raceway near Tampa, Florida, driving a sprint car, and even then trying to grow a mustache to make him look a little bit older. Jeff Gordon then moved to Thursday and Saturday Night Thunder, and we saw him race against the best of them, beating such drivers like Rich Fogler. He won the championship in midgets and Silver Crown cars. And now he comes to NASCAR Winston Cup competition, and in his third full season of competition, he becomes only the 22nd driver in history to wear the crown of NASCAR Winston Cup champion. Our sincere congratulations to champ Jeff Gordon. Winston Cup champion in history and only driver other than Dale Earnhardt to win the title in less than 100 career starts. Our congratulations.
Here in the Gordon pits, they are very, very conscious about wearing the DuPont hats all year long. But a moment ago, they didn't mind taking them off because they came in and passed out these ones. 1995 NASCAR Winston Cup champion, and they all got them on, including this guy right here, Rick Hendrick. And Rick, my friend, it's been a long time coming, 11 years, but congratulations.
Well, it really is. It's, you know, we worked awful hard, and happy for everybody. The whole organization, motorsports, and dealerships, and all of our friends, it's been, can't believe it's happened, but it's nice to have his hat.
Well, I know that the yellow has come out, Rick. You're going to come in momentarily, but you got a great one. This is the first of what could be many.
I hope so.
Well, we're going to back out of the way. We'll talk with Ray Evernham and the crew in a moment, but they're going to get busy because Jeff Gordon, the 1995 Winston Cup champion, is going to make a pit stop.
The caution is for debris on the racetrack, and Rick Hendrick's previous best in NASCAR Winston Cup competition as a car owner was second in 1991 with Ricky Rudd. And Jeff Gordon also had a close moment. Let's watch him come down and enter his pit stall.
He stops. They start changing the tires. See a chassis adjustment back in the rear. Jack goes down. He comes out, and he and Elliott almost make contact, and we see Earnhardt still sitting there.
So Dale Earnhardt lost a lot of track position on that pit stop. Wow. But Jeff Gordon made it out okay, did not have contact with Bill Elliott, although it was very, very close. While we have an opportunity and we are under caution, we're going to take another break. The Chevy Monte Carlo roared into 95 at Daytona with Sterling Marlin's second consecutive win. And the Monte Carlo just kept on winning. And winning. And winning. But Chevy's momentum could not be stopped as Jeff Gordon clinched the manufacturer's championship with a win at Darlington in the season's 23rd race. Let's take a look at Jeff Gordon's crew cam pit stop through the eyes of the crew cam. Who's wearing that BP?
Patrick Donahue, the fellow who cleans the windshield. There he is. We see him spraying on the windshield. Now start rubbing that stuff. Get that windshield good and clean. Come on, Patrick. That up, baby. Man, he's making 100 miles an hour down hand, and he's back across the wall. And away the car goes.
Oh, there's the close call as Jeff went out, but everything's okay. Just a two-tire stop for Jeff.
And here comes Jeff Gordon.
Yeah, I started to say that. He's coming down the inside, but couldn't quite make the pass on to Elliott that time. You see Ted Musgrave in that picture. Ted is a lap down. His car got to handle a little bit of hill there in that long first green flag run. Got a lap down.
Waltrip and Earnhardt also, we saw them at the back of this line. Now Martin once again drops down low on the racetrack to try to get a momentum build up off the fourth corner down the straightaway to get the lap back, but nope.
start, and we saw right at the top of the picture was able to get by Darrell Walker. Now he closes up right on the back bumper of Ted Musgrave and Jeff Gordon.
Nice move to the inside of Elliott there, and he's going to take the lead back from Ricky Rudd and keep Martin a lap down.
Yeah, put Martin a lap down. Martin is in 24th position, so there are now 23 cars on the lead lap.
There's Jeff Gordon's roof cam looking ahead to Bill Elliott.
You see that little yellow thing on the windshield of Jeff Gordon's car?
Uh-huh.
That's an inspection sticker. When the car passes inspection, NASCAR puts it on the windshield.
Looks like it's about to blow off. Now, what happens if that sticker blows off?
Well, that's just so that as he goes, that's just so that, that as he rolls the car out of the inspection area, that signifies to all the rest of the competitive inspectors that he has passed.
Just kidding. I don't think there are very few things that are going to reverse Jeff Gordon being the champion as at the moment.
No, I don't either.
No, he's got that in his pocket.
He has led one lap. That, of course, was the deciding moment when he led that lap. It gave him 5 bonus points, and that clinched it for him. He started 8th, currently 4th. He's been as low as 9th, and that came on lap number 6. Could be the first $4 million man. He's going to win a contingency awards like the Bush Pole Award, the Gatorade Circle of Champions, the Hard Charger, the DuPont Award. When you add all of that to the Winston Point Fund, the race purses, it could all total more than $4 million at the Waldorf Astoria in Midtown Manhattan the first week in December, and we'll be there. They're second, third, and fourth. Elliott right behind Rudd, and Gordon's right behind Bill.
We're speculating correctly during the commercial. What's happened is he's one of those cars that's been on only 2 tires, and he also took one round of bite after the car had been very tight. Now the car has just gone completely 180 degrees in the other direction. It is very, very loose, and so he's had to back out of the throttle. He's lost about 7 or 8 spots. That's also the reason that Mark Martin has come in for another unscheduled start.
That Jeff Gordon is going to make a pit stop here to see if they can't correct this problem. That has really dropped him back in the standings.
Right now, Jeff Gordon is about 3/4 of a lap behind Dale Earnhardt. We see Ray Evernham talking to Jeff, telling him exactly what they're going to do. And I would expect he said, pit next time, and we'll change 4 tires and do this and do that.
You're looking at the second youngest champion in NASCAR Winston Cup history. Of course, Bill Rexford, who won the championship in 1950, was 23 years, 229 days. Jeff Gordon, who wraps up the championship here today, is 24 years and 100 days old. The third on the list is Richard Petty, and then Terry Labonte and Herb Thomas, the youngest 5 drivers ever to win a title. Jeff is on pit road now. He passes by Dave Marcus, who is getting routine service, but Jeff Gordon is headed for an unscheduled pit stop.
And here is Gordon in the pit. Apparently what they did, Rick Hendrick told me, they made a calculated gamble. He took on 2 tires, trying to get track position, and it didn't pay off. The car got so loose he couldn't drive it. So they came in, they got to change 4 tires, take a rubber out of the front, and try to tighten the car up a little bit with some air pressure. Jeff's car was just getting so loose, they didn't want to have him win the championship with the car backed into the wall somewhere in Atlanta. So 24.4, he is down and away.
we can see that making those adjustments really slow those pit stops down. So that's why they want to do it with air pressure as much as they can, so that they don't have to take a person to make that chassis adjustment.
And Ray, a moment ago, we saw you on pit road for a lengthy stop. What all's going on with the car?
Well, it's been acting, been doing crazy things, not responding to changes, and now he's lost the feel. He thought there was something loose in the front end, so evidently something's gone wrong in the steering system, and it doesn't get any better. We're going to have to park it. The car's kind of doing what it wants. It's turning on itself. It's not even going straight down the straightaway. Now, we're really happy for DuPont, Rick Hendrick especially, Coca-Cola, all the people that helped us win this championship. But, you know, it's going to be a long winter because, you know, we really wanted to run good here. Everybody supporting us, it's a great feeling. Kind of disappointed. We really had hoped to run good here, and we're just not going to do it today.
Ray, if you had to have a bad race, not a bad one to pick, you clinch the championship, and then the car goes away.
Yeah, but, you know, it's a tough business. You're only as good as your last race, so we're going to have to hold our breath all the way going to Daytona. But, you know, we are really happy that we clinched the championship, but we like to race, and we didn't get to race much today, Jared.
Well, they may hold their breath, but they're still going to, between here and Daytona, they're going to celebrate a little bit in New York at the Waldorf, and we'll be there with them.
And you're only as good as your last championship, and he's the champ, so hats off to him. Back at Atlanta, we're riding with the 95 Winston Cup champion, Jeff Gordon. The amount of money that Champ has received over the years has increased. Shows that so has the number of showroom floor cars that they could buy with that money. Jeff Gordon in 1995. He will win somewhere near $3.7 million, and with that can buy 212 1995 Monte Carlos. So put that in your encyclopedia of little-known facts. Or facts that nobody really cares about.
$3.7 million. That's about what I earned in my career in Winston.
What I want to know is, what in the world did you do with $77,000 back in 65, Ned? You must have had one heck of a party with that.
Man, I was rich. But now, that wasn't point money. That was point money and earnings during
is
the year.
That right?
Yeah.
Man. Here's Jerry.
Guys, we're about to see Jeff Gordon's final pit stop. And here's what they've done. They have all changed positions. Ray Evernham, the crew chief, said, I've always wanted to change tires, so I'm going to change the front tire. Rick Hendrick, the car owner, said, they have always wanted to go across and clean the windshield, so Rick Hendrick is going to clean the windshield. Ed Guzzo, who works in the shop as a shop mechanic, he said, I've always wanted to jack, so I'm going to jack the car. They're also going to change the, they make the front tire changer, Michael Troyer, the crew chief for this stop. Patrick Donahue, who's the parts specialist, he's going to change the rear tires. So take a look at a makeshift pit crew on a championship team in Jeff Gordon's final pit stop for 1995. Here he comes down pit road, 55 miles an hour, and look at Ray Evernham. Folks, this may take a while. Ray Evernham's going to change the right front. Rick Hendrick doing a wonderful job on the windshield. Jack will try again. That's Ed Guzzo, Jack in the car. He's a shop mechanic. First time to jack the car, can you tell? And here's Evernham now. As the sun starts to go down, he's on the left side of the car. Taking a while now. Let's see. Lug nuts come off. 23 seconds, 24 seconds. How many laps are left here today? Well, they'll be out before it's over anyway. And Rick is still working on the windshield. Almost stumbles over Ray Evernham. And the left rear is on. And come on, Ray. Ray. Yeah, get them all tight right now. 38 and 39.6, but he's the champion anyway.
But he'll probably get black flag for going over the air hose.
That's right, he ran over the air hose.
Hey, Rick, now, that had to be a treat going over and cleaning the windshield. You did a pretty good job.
Well, I think I cleaned the windshield faster than they changed the tires.
let me get Ray over here. Ray, let me get Ray Evernham over here. Ray, hey. So we clocked that tire change.
What's that?
That pit stop was a blistering 39.6 seconds.
Well, all right, so we got a little work to do, you know, when we're not championship caliber yet, but I had a little trouble with the gun.
Hey, the Jeff Radio did it, said great pit stop. He said he really likes the fact that the windshield is very, very clean.
He also said as bad as that thing was driving, he said, why couldn't we find some volunteer to take over the seat for a while?
Hey, they're having some fun, and rightfully so. They deserve it, and they've earned it this year.
That's right. You might as well do some crazy stuff when you're the champion and everything has been wrapped up. Well, after that, let's take a break. Catch your breath here just a little bit. The lead continues to be held by Dale Earnhardt here in the Napa 500. And the most important person on that list, Jeff Gordon, because when he did that, the championship was his. But the championship goes to Jeff Gordon. There he is. He did not have a good race. Jeff Gordon wound up 32nd, 14 laps down to Dale Earnhardt, but he is the champ. Here's Bill Weber with Andy Petrie.
Andy, congratulations.
Yeah, he got it. I want to congratulate Jeff and Ray. They deserve to win this championship. They worked hard for it all season, and my hat's off to him. Ray's a good friend of mine, and I just wanted to congratulate him, too. I want to go find him personally and congratulate him. I know how it feels, and I hate coming up short, but... You know, I've had to lose it. I guess Ray's not a bad one to lose it to.
Great career to work with Dale Earnhardt.
Oh, I tell you what, not many people get this kind of opportunity, and I just can't, I just thank the good Lord for letting me do this and have this opportunity to do it.
Okay, Andy Petrie, the winning crew chief here today as Dale Earnhardt takes the checkered flag and Gordon brings home the championship.
And the championship crew chief is being hoisted on the shoulders of the other crew members and paraded down victory lane as people come along and high-five Ray Evernham, who has... managed to take Jeff Gordon to the Winston Cup Championship in 1995.
Good thing I'm a crew chief. I'd have to walk.
There, you did it to yourself again. Jeff Gordon is on the racetrack taking a victory lap, and everybody is standing and cheering, and he's looping it here on the main straightaway. That is great.
I didn't think they had enough power to do that, but it did. Congratulations, Jeff Gordon, and also to Dale Earnhardt. A couple of great performances.
I'm sure there have got to be some very emotional moments ahead for young Jeff Gordon.
He'll make a great champion.
It hasn't been too long ago that we saw him racing Rich Vogler and the other great open wheel drivers, and now he has won the championship and proved himself the best in stock cars.
They are just now...
All right, get set. Just get ready.
They are around the 1995 Winston Cup champion. All trying to get a close look at the DuPont Wonderboy Rainbow Warrior car.
Was not going to get out of the race car until these youngsters were here. And Jeff, first of all, let me congratulate you on a wonderful year.
Well, thank you very much, Jerry. And this is just a spectacular day. I know a race car wasn't much today, but it's been a heck of a year. And before I get into that, this is Jerry, and she's got leukemia. And this year we Ray and I have done something, and because of this championship, we wanted to contribute a lot more to that. The Racing for a Reason with Cure 2000, and because of this championship, we're going to donate $25,000, and we've had help from the Speedway Children's Charities, Coca-Cola, and DuPont to contribute to that. And we just want to say thank you very much. You're the sweetest thing there is, and we really love you, okay? All right. And then, we got that championship, man. I mean, it's just... greatest thing in the world. I mean, there just aren't words that can describe the way I feel. I feel like I've been out there making like 300 championship victory laps because I wasn't doing much racing out there. We just, I don't know, we just didn't hit it today.
What about that final pit stop? Did you see Ray Evernham and Rick Hendrick and those guys? I mean, you were there for quite a while. Did you read any books or anything? I mean, did you have any second thoughts about going back on the racetrack when those guys put the tires on?
You know, I didn't think about it at the time until I got back out there, and I was like, wait a minute. Am I safe out here? I saw Rick cleaning the windshield. And, I mean, that was just the kind of day we had. We had to enjoy the day and not worry about what was going on the racetrack. Unfortunately, you know, Dale Earnhardt did everything he had to do. Man, he had an awesome car today. But, you know, that was pretty neat. As a matter of fact, I was asking some people if they wanted to sit in my seat because, man, we just weren't getting the job done out there. But, you know, I got to thank a lot of people. DuPont. They've been great, great contributors to this organization, and we couldn't have done it without them. Rick Hendrick's the greatest car owner, and Ray Evernham, man, he's the best crew chief out there.
Now where are you going? If the season's over, you're the champion, where are you headed?
Well, you know, I mean, I know I'm going to Hawaii. Brooke and I are on our way to Hawaii for about 10 days just to totally get away, and you know, maybe there'll be some race fans over in Hawaii, but it's unbelievable. I think we really need to sit down on a beach somewhere far, far away from here for it to really sink in. I don't really know exactly what's going on right now. It's just my head's spinning.
Well, Jeff Gordon, it is indeed a dream come true. From all of us, we congratulate you. They have called him Wonder Boy all year, and from now on, it'll be one word, champion. Bob?
Jeff Gordon started his very first NASCAR Winston Cup's career on the day that Richard Petty retired 3 years ago, and it was at this race. And now, 3 years later, he brings home his first Winston Cup championship. What a happy boy he is, and a great celebration going on down below. We've got a half hour post-race program for you. Don't go away. We have a full half hour to fill, and we'll fill it with a lot of really good stuff, so stay with us when we come back to Atlanta Motor Speedway, where Jeff has won the championship, Dale has won the race. Back at Atlanta Motor Speedway, where the race has been concluded, Dale Earnhardt wins the race. There is the 95 NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Jeff Gordon. He is currently on the back of a big hauler that will carry him around the racetrack to the delight, I'm sure, of all the fans that have gathered here. Quite a mob scene down there here on the start-finish line and in victory lane. Here's Bill Weber.
Now on a day where we've crowned a series champion.
Bed as everybody is staying around to salute the champion. Now let's take a look at the final point standings. After 31 hard-fought races, Jeff Gordon comes home the champion, going to pick up $1.3 million. Sterling Marlin moved up to third in the point standings, and that means an additional $110,000. That's how much more third pays than fourth.
And once again, this is just the Winston money. There's going to be more to add on to this total.
Bobby Labonte stays in 10th. Bill Elliott moved up to 8th, putting Ricky Rudd back to 9th, and that means an additional $20,000.
And there at 11 through 15, Morgan Shepherd stayed in 11th today. Michael Waltrip moved up a couple spots. Dale Jarrett dropped to one spot. Bobby Hamilton he's in 14th, and Derek Cope winds up in 15th place.
Taking a look at 16 through 20 final finishers in the point standings. Again, the bonus money is over there on the right. Even the 20th pace driver in the point standings will walk off with a bonus check of $25,000. Now 21 through 25.
Rick Mast, Ward Burton, Lake Speed, Ricky Craven, and Dick Trickle. Dick Trickle gets 25th place.
It's been a long time coming, this feeling I've got. Things will always go your way, such a long shot. Been so deep in the hole, thought I'd never crawl out. Anything can happen, oh, I know that now. Hey, one slip, one fall, turn the head, can't change it all. Step ahead, step behind, a blink of an eye at the wrong time. No stop, east and west, spin the wheel, hope for the best. No regrets, it's all we know. Who drives every group?
Cups, and the second place man, Jeff Gordon, inherits the lead, giving him 5 bonus points as he clinches the 1995 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. Jeff Gordon wins the NASCAR Winston Cup title by just 34 points over Dale Earnhardt. But for Jeff Gordon, it was a spectacular year, winning the title in only his 3rd year on the NASCAR Winston Cup circuit. For a young man who has achieved an awful lot in a short time, this was a very emotional day.
The Winston Cup championship is just the ultimate thing, and now here I am achieving it, and it's too good to be true, but I know it's reality, it's happening, but it's like there are no words to describe what it feels like to be able to achieve this goal. It's unbelievable.
Several times during the season, this team could have given up, but the crew, nicknamed the Rainbow Warriors, well, they just don't know the meaning of quit. First, that non-approved hub at Charlotte, but still, they rallied to capture the pole shortly thereafter at Dover. Then, following a wreck during qualifying at New Hampshire, Gordon comes from 21st starting position to win the race. And at Darlington, Gordon battled an ill-handling race car all day long, only to come back and win the Southern 500. For Jeff Gordon and his crew, this 1995 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship is very well deserved.
It couldn't have been any sweeter than to race Dale Earnhardt for a championship. I mean, you know, he's the greatest Winston Cup driver out there, the greatest driver I'll ever race against. And you know, to be able to, keep him from winning his 8th championship, it makes it a lot more special. And I don't mean that in a negative way. I really mean that in a very, very positive way.
So it's been a long, grueling season in which Jeff Gordon and his crew battled with the best veterans in the business and won. Jeff Gordon, though, says this championship is one he'll remember forever, one that he'll never take for granted.
I never, ever would have guessed in a million years even my whole career. I mean, I could be 40 years old, winning my first Winston Cup championship, racing Winston Cup for 20 years, and I would be saying, this is the greatest, you know? And so here it is 3 years, and I don't know what to do. I mean, I don't know what to do next, you know? But it's something that we're going to enjoy right now and something that's great to think about for the rest of the year.
Well, it all came down to this bone-chilling, blustery November the 12th here in Atlanta, Georgia. A long way from back in Daytona Beach when that jack problem had Jeff Gordon derailed early in the year, playing catch-up from the month of February on. But it all ends here today with his first ever NASCAR Winston Cup Series championship, the second youngest driver to ever grab the NASCAR title. We hope you've enjoyed our look back at the 1995 season. It's been a great year. 1996 looms just ahead with better racing than ever before. So long, everybody.